We shall now talk about variables. Variables is central to programming because you can think of programming as simply manipulating or changing the value of variables. So first, let's try to understand what are variables. Data is the reason why programs exist, and data is processed by programs we write on computers. Now, the data which is available needs to be stored somewhere in the main memory of the computer, also called as the RAM or the random access memory. Now, data can be of the type constant or also called as a literal. An example of a constant or literal would be the value of pi 3.142. An example of a data which is changing is, let us say I want to read in the salary, I want to read in the age, and I want to read in the weight of different people. And after reading in, I want to calculate the average weight, average salary, and average age. You can be sure that the salary, age, and weight is not going to be the same for all the people. Say I am going to read about 50 people. So here I will require to read values into a memory location and indicate that memory location is going to have contents which are going to constantly change. That is, they are going to keep changing. This changing memory location is referred to as a variable. Now, as I remarked, changing data is stored in a memory location called as variable. Now, variables are the location or places in the computer memory which is used for temporary data storage in the main memory of the computer. Since a variable refers to a memory location of a computer, variables occupy certain space in the computer memory. Now, we have different types of data. We have data like numbers, we have data of characters, we have data of images, sound files, etc. So different data types or types of data is required to hold this. For example, a memory location which can hold numbers doesn't make sense to assign it characters because it will be meaningless. Similarly, a memory location which is reserved for an image cannot, of course, hold numbers. So integer type of variables are meant to hold integer type of data. Character type of variables can hold character type of data. So let's take a look at a small diagram. Suppose I have a declaration like this. I say int a. I'm just showing this in capital so you can see this clearly. When I say int a, it tells me a is a type of integer variable. Let's say I read in a value of 262 from the keyboard. So its value is 262. Name of the memory location is referred to by a. The address of this particular memory location, let's assume it is 2224. So there are a few things associated with the variable. One is a name, one is a type, one is a value, and one is the address of a variable. Now, the reason we give names to memory location is because we want to have certain identification of that memory location. Similarly, variables are given name so as to identify the type and memory location. For example, if I have to declare a variable of the type character, I can declare something like this. Gender is a variable of the type character. Roll number is always going to be a full number, not going to have fractions or decimal places. I have declared it as integer. Height can be a real number because somebody's height can be 4.5, somebody's can be 5.6. So that's why I declare it as a real number or float. Then let's say somebody's wealth is really high, maybe a big guy in the world. Okay, so we can declare his or her wealth as double of data type, double. Now, for all of this, with the exception of character, the size of data simply varies or depends upon hardware to hardware, and the size of these particular data types from int to double is determined by the machine. The size of char is always going to be 1 byte. As I had shown you in my diagram earlier, okay, just to keep that diagram fresh, okay, you have to Choose meaningful names for a variable. The first thing is, when you're giving a name for a variable, don't give it any name that comes into your mind at that moment. Choose a name of a variable that is related to the purpose of the variable. Suppose I'm finding the sum of two numbers. So I can always call the first one N1 and the second one N2 and the third one, which is going to store the result of N1 plus N2 as sum. Instead of this, if instead of N1 I had given Z1, 2, or let me say A, B, C, X, Y, Z, these are also okay names, but they do not relate to the purpose of why that variable is used, and you will end up confusing yourself when you're trying to understand the program. Okay, and always give variables which are not likely to get mixed up. Okay, don't give something like this. Don't give A capital 1 and then don't give another variable with the same name A1. You're going to confuse yourself with these kind of names. A good practice in C is, if you're defining variables, generally give small meaningful names to them. There is something called loops. If you have taken a look at algorithms, we have used indices like I, J. So I'm giving them short names so I can quickly type them and get the work done. So for local variables, loop indices like I, J, give very short names. We will deal with something called as external variables later on. For those, you're preferably better off giving a longer or a more meaningful variable name, because they are going to be more likely than not shared across a number of programs. So I hope this gives you a very gentle introduction into what is variables. And in the next session, we will talk about how we name them and different aspects of variables which we have to learn to use them in C programming.